Hello friends, good morning. Today we are going to learn about the application of the dimensional analysis. First application, to obtain the relation between the units of physical quantity into different system of units. And second application, to check the dimensional consistency or validity. And third application, to obtain the relation one physical quantity to the other physical quantity. Now, first one, to obtain the relation between the units of the physical quantity in two different system of the units. Means, in previous lecture, we have seen the system. System means MKS system, CGS system, MKSA system, FPS system. In them, if you want to convert MKS to CGS, MKS system, MKS system, in other side, CGS system, CGS system. MKS system means mass measured in kilogram. In MKS system, mass measured in kilogram, length measured in meter, and time measured in second in MKS system. Now, dimensional analysis. In dimensional analysis, mass, length and time means MLT. MLT. So we can write here MLT. MLT form. In MKS system, MLT. Mass, M means mass, mass measured in MK system, mass measured in kilogram, kg, in short form of kilogram is kg, length measured in meter, and time measured in second, time measured in second. Now in CGS system, in CGS system, conversion from MK system to the CGS system. Again, I can write M, L and T. M, L, T. MLT in MKS form and MLT in CGS form. Now, in CGS form, C means centimeter, G means gram and S means second. Means in CGS system, MLT, M means mass, mass measured in CGS system, gram, mass measured in CGS system is gram, length measured in CGS system is centimeter, and time measured in second. Now, we know that in standard 10th, in chapter, in subject science and mathematics, in both the subjects, we have learned about the kilogram and gram. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Means we can write 1 kg is equal to 10 power 3 gram. Means here 1 kg, that is in MKS system, and 10 power 3 gram, that is in CGS system for mass. So 1 kg is equal to 10 power 3 grams. So I can write here 10 power 3. Understood? Mass in MKS system 1 kg. Mass in CGS system 1000 gram. 1 kg is equal to 10 power 3 gram. So here in MKS system 1 kg. And in CGS system, 10 power 3 gram, which is equal to 10 power 3 gram. Now length measured in MK system in meter. Length measured in MK system is in meter. And length measured in CGS system. Length measured in CGS system in centimeter. So 1 meter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Means 1 meter, which is equal to 10^2 centimeter. So here 1 meter, that is length measured in the MK system, and 10^2 centimeter, that is length measured in CGS system. So left hand side, length in MK system in meter, and right hand side, length in CGS system in centimeter. 1 meter, 1 meter, which is equal to 10^2 centimeter. So here I can write 10^2 centimeter. Understood? Mass, length. Now time. In MK system, time measured in second. Also in CGS system, time measured in second. 1 second is equal to 1 second. Time 1 second in MK system, which is equal to 1 second that is used in CGS system. Time in both the system, time measured in second. So no change in time measurement in MKS, either MKS or CGS system. MK system, mass, length, time. In CGS system, mass, length and time. So for simplicity, here we can write 10^0. 10^0 means 1. 10^0 means 1. Now first application of dimensional analysis, that is suggest us to obtain the relation between the units of physical quantity in two different system of units. Means two different system of units, means two different system, MK system and CG system. In both the systems, unit are different. In MK system, MLT. In CGS system, MLT. In MK system, kilogram, meter, second. In CGS system, gram, centimeter and second. Now take one example. First example related to the first application. Example. Now I want to convert energy, which is equal to work. Energy which is equal to work done. Dimensional formula of energy, which is exactly equal to the dimensional formula of work done, W. Dimensional formula of energy is equal to dimensional formula of work done is equal to M1 L2 T minus 2. M1 L2 T minus 2. So I can write M1 L2 T minus 2. Now in MK system, here MK system is equal to CGS system. MK system, in MK system, dimensional formula M1 L2 T minus 2, and the unit of energy in MK system, that is joule. Unit in MK system is joule. Unit of energy is joule. And dimensional formula M1 L2 T minus 2. M1 L2 T t minus 2. In CGS system, I want to convert one system to the another system. So, I can convert MKS to CGS. Dimensional formula of energy, M1 means mass, dimension of mass 1, dimension of length 2, dimension of time is minus 2. So, here I can write MKS equal to CGS, M, which is equal to 10 power 3 M. M, which is equal to 10 power 3 M means in MKS system, mass M, which is equal to 10 power 3 M. So, in MKS system, mass M, so I can write 10 power 3 M. Instead of M, I can write 10 power 3 M. Instead of M, I can write 10 power 3 M, and power of M is 1. Now, length L in MK system and 10 power 2 L in CGS system. Length in MK system L, length in CGS system 10 power 2 L. L. Instead of L, I can write here 10 power 2 L. 10 power 2 L. And power of L, 2. Now, time T. In MK system, time measured in second. And in CGS system, time also measured in second. So, no change in time measurement, t power minus 2. Now, simplify the equation. Therefore, M1 L2 t minus 2, which is equal to 10 power 3, 10 power 2, 2 into 2, 4, 10 power 3 M1. 10 power 2, power 2, 2 into 2, 4, 10 power 4, L, 2, and T minus 2. Therefore, M1, L2, T minus 2, which is equal to 10 power 3, 10 power 4, 3 plus 4, 10 power 3, 10 power 4, 10 power 3 plus 4 means 10 power 7, 10 power 7, M1, L2, T minus 2. In MKS system, unit of work or unit of energy is joule. Unit of work or unit of energy is joule. 1 J-O-U-L-E, joule. 1 joule. Unit of energy, because here dimensional formula of energy is joule. Now, in CGS system, unit of energy, 10 power 7 times erg, E-R-G. Understand? Conversion from one system to the another system. 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 erg. That is most important result for us in many competitive examination like JEE, NEET or GUJCET. Sometimes paper setter asks the question, 1 joule is equal to how much erg? 1 joule is equal to how much erg? So you can write easily, 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 erg. So conversion from one system to another system. Now, second example. MKS system, CGS system. Now in MKS system, in MKS system, dimensional formula of force. In MKS system, dimensional formula of force. M1 L1 T minus 2. In dimensional formula of force. Dimensional formula of force. Here dimensional formula of energy or work done. Dimensional formula of force is equal to M1 L1 T minus 2. Now, M in MK system, M measured in kilogram. In CGS system, M is equal to 10 power 3 M measured in gram. Mass measured in kilogram, 1 M is equal to 10 power 3 M. So, right hand side, write down M is equal to 10 power 3 M. 10 power 3 M. And power of M is 1 into L. L is equal to 10 power 2 L. 10 power 2 L. And power of L is 1. So here 1 into time T is equal to 10 power 0 T means 10 power 0 means 1 means T is equal to T. So I can write T 10 power 0 T and power minus 2 minus 2. Therefore, force is equal to dimensional formula of force is equal to M1 L1 T minus 2 is equal to 10 power 3 M 10 power 3 M 1 10 power 2 L1 into 10 power 2 L1 10 power 0 into minus 2 means 10 power 0 T raised to minus 2 T power minus 2. Therefore M1 L1 T minus 2 dimensional formula of force which is equal to 10 power 3 10 power 2 10 power 0 10 power 3 into 10 power 2 into 10 power 0 when 3 terms are in multiplication power of each term in addition 10 power 3 3 plus 2 plus 0 3 plus 2 plus 0 means 3 plus 2 is equal to 5 10 power 5 M1 L1 T minus 2 means in MKS system unit of force is Newton. In MKS system unit of force is Newton means 1 Newton 1 Newton which is equal to 1 Newton is equal to 10 power 5 9 that is also most important result for us for examination point of view JEE, NEET and GUDSET and many more competitive examination the relation between Newton and Dyne 1 Newton in MKS system which is equal to 10 power 5 Dyne in CGS system. Understood? The first application of dimensional analysis to obtain the relation between the units of physical quantity in two different system of unit. So MKS, CGS and example first energy, first example of energy, and second example of force. For energy point of view, 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 arc. For force point of view, 1 newton is equal to 10 power 5 dyne. Dear students, please note down all the terms and all the things carefully. Most important for us. If you want to take a screenshot, okay. Now, second application. Second application number 2, to verify dimensional consistency consistency, or we can say to check the validity of physical equation, to verify the physical equation. Question arises in our mind, how we can verify the dimensional consistency? Means, if we have any physical equation, V is equal to V0 plus AT, x is equal to x0 plus at plus, understood, and x is equal to x0 plus v0t plus half at square. In first equation, 3 terms. In second equation, 4 terms. All the equation having 2 or more than 2 terms, all the terms having dimensionally same or dimensionally equal. So, how I can verify the dimensionally equal? From second application, we can verify that equation. For example, if I want to add some physical quantity, magnitude of physical quantity, if you want to add any magnitude of physical quantity, or you want to subtract any magnitude of physical quantity, you cannot directly add or subtract. You can add and subtract then only physical quantity if the dimension of physical quantities are same, right hand side and left hand side, both the side, which is dimensionally valid. If that equation does not verify the consistency, does not valid equation, then we can say that is not follow the rules of the dimensional consistency. So, force, if I take the one example, force, directly we cannot add the force in thermodynamic temperature. Force, if I want to add the force in here plus thermodynamic temperature, that is not possible. Same way, velocity. Velocity and pressure cannot add directly. So, first we want to check whether the equation dimensionally valid or not. How we can verify that equation? So, we can see in this application. Understood? Without dimensional analysis, we cannot add or subtract directly any physical quantity. Same way, if length measured in meter, understood? If I have two connecting rods, two connecting pipes, length of the first one is in meter and length of second one is in centimeter. First one, length of the first one in meter, length of the second one in centimeter. So we cannot add directly length of the both the pipes, both the rods. So first length of the first pipe in meter, so we can convert length of the first pipe in centimeter, and length of the second pipe already given in centimeter, then you can add directly. And second situation, length of the first pipe in meter remains as it is, length of the second pipe convert from centimeter to meter. Now you can add length of the both the pipes, understood? So by dimensional analysis we can verify the equation that is physically valid, dimensionally valid or not. If any equation which is not verified, which is not dimensionally valid, so we can say that is physically wrong. Which equation dimensionally correct, that is follows the rule of dimensional consistency. If equation fails to follow the rules of the dimensional consistency, so we can say that equation is dimensionally wrong. If it follows the rules, means dimensionally correct, and the dimensionally correct equation which is not correct exactly may not be correct because some special characters, some special functions like trigonometric function, trigonometric function, exponential function, and logarithm function. Trigonometric function, exponential function, and logarithm function, which is dimensionless. If any equation has an trigonometric function, exponential function, logarithm function, then we cannot verify that equation with the help of dimensional analysis. And if any equation has a numerical values, so we cannot verify that equation by dimensional analysis. So that equation follows the rules and that is dimensionally correct, we cannot say that is exactly correct, because trigonometric function, exponential function, logarithm function and numerical values. But which equation fails to follow the rules of the dimensional consistency, which are not dimensionally valid, that is exactly wrong equation, physically and dimensionally, that is wrong. Understood? Now we can check that dimensional consistency by some examples. First example, centripetal force F is equal to mv square by r. Uniform circular motion, force of uniform circular motion F is equal to mv square by r. Now in left hand side, dimensional formula, force m1 L1 T minus 2 is equal to mv square by r, dimension of mass m1 n2 velocity, m0 l1 t-2 divided by length r, radius measured in length, radius measured in length l1. Here l power 2 t power minus 1 into 2, therefore m1 l1 t-2 is equal to m1 into m0 l2 t-2 divided by l1. Therefore m1 l1 t-2 is equal to m1 l2 in denominator l power 1, l1 moves in numerator l power minus 1, 2 minus 1 l1 and t minus, which is LHS exactly equal to the RHS. Here LHS exactly equal to the RHS means that equation follows the rules of the dimensional consistency, means that is valid equation in left hand side, in right hand side, in both the side dimensions of MLT are same, therefore that equation is dimensionally valid equation. Now second example, x is equal to x0, v0t plus half at square. If any equation having more than two terms, here equation having 1, 2, 3 and 4 terms. Understood? Here equation having 1, 2, 3 and 4 terms. So we can check dimensional anal consistency of each term for x, x0, v0t and half at square. If all the 4 terms having same dimension, so we can say that equation is dimensionally valid, otherwise it is not valid. First one, x means length, here x in length measured in L1, dimensional formula of the first term, dimensional formula of first term, x is equal to L1. Dimensional formula of second term, x0 is equal to again length L1. Dimensional formula of third term, v0 is equal to dimensional formula of velocity, m0 L1 t-1 into t, m0 L0 t1. m0 is equal to m0, l1 l0 l1, t-1 t+1 means -1 + 1 is equal to 0 means l1. Now fourth term, first term, second term, third term, now fourth term, half a t square, here numerical value which is dimensionless. A means acceleration, dimensional formula of acceleration, acceleration is equal to m0 l1 t-2 and t square into m0 l1 t2 is equal to m0 l1 l1 l2 then t2, here m0 l0 t2, l1 l0 L1, L0 means 1 plus 0, L1. T minus 2, T plus 2. Minus 2 plus 2 means 0 is equal to L1. Dimension of right hand side L1, dimension of left hand side L1, dimension of right hand side here equation having 3 terms. Dimension of right left hand side L1, right hand side L1 means here equation having same dimension is here equation having 4 terms, each term having same dimension L1 means that equation is dimensionally valid equation. Correct equation. Now third example. Third example that is given in NCERT textbook, example number 2.15. Example 2.15. Let us consider an equation half mv square is equal to mgh. Half mv square is equal to mgh. Half mv square is equal to mgh, where m is mass of the body, v is the velocity, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height. Check whether the equation is dimensionally correct. So here I can check the equation dimensionally correct or not. So first LHS is equal to half mv square is equal to 1 by 2 dimensionless, dimension of mass m1, dimension of velocity m0, L1 T minus 1 power 2 is equal to M1 M0 L1 into 2 L2 T minus 1 into 2 T minus 2 is equal to M1 L2 T minus 2. LHS. Now RHS, right hand side, is equal to mgh is equal to mass of the body m1, g acceleration due to gravity, dimensional formula of acceleration and dimensional formula of acceleration due to gravity both are same, m0 l1 t minus 2 into height measured in length l1 is equal to M1 L1 L1 L2 into T minus 2 M1 L2 T minus 2 RHS LHS M1 L2 T minus 2 means in left hand side and in right hand side both the side dimensions are same, therefore we can say that equation is dimensionally correct. Here LHS is equal to RHS, so we can say above equation dimensionally valid. Understood? How we can check the consistency of the equation, means validity of the equation. If right hand side and left hand side both the side having same dimension, so we can say that equation is dimensionally valid and physically valid. If Any equation contains more than two terms. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. All the terms having same dimension. All the terms having same dimension. If any one term having not same dimension, the dimensions are different, then we can say that equation does not follow the rules of dimensional consistency. And that equation is dimensionally wrong and physically wrong. If any equation fails the consistency test, it is proved wrong, but if it passes, it is not proved right. Understood? If any equation that is follows the rules of dimensional consistency, so that is dimensionally true, but which is not exactly true, because if any equation having logarithm, trigonometric or arithmetic function or some numerical value that are dimensionless, so we can say if any equation which is dimensionally correct, we cannot say that is exactly correct. If any equation dimensionally wrong, that must be exactly wrong equation. That is the second application of dimensional analysis. Now, third application of the dimensional analysis: to obtain the one physical quantity to the another physical quantity, that we will see in next video lecture. Thank you.